here.
Mm-hmm.
And then airplane is coming next day.
Okay. And
next picture. Your next picture, okay.
From what you gathered, because obviously you couldn't see the Navy Annex.
Yeah. So I looks like the my shot here, see?
Just like
okay. That's why I saw the oh my god. People might be moved to Navy Annex building.
Right.
And so I said, yeah, big problem is maybe hit the Navy Annex. The loud noise. That's why I said running out, and then I look at the Navy Annex building. It's not.
It wasn't touched.
Yeah, it wasn't touched. Oh, then what? And then I keep running to the Pentagon side. And then I saw kind of a black and then orange colors, this black smoke and the orange color film keep coming up. Oh my god.
Okay, so now back to the plane and your description of it. You're saying that all you really notice or remember are black wings.
Yeah, black wing, and then one the kind of the
okay, let me I have pictures of the planes I want to show you as well.
Same airplane.
Well, these are different. This is the same style airplane.
Yeah.
That they say it was.
That's what I thought. You also just kind of one.
Okay, let me show.
One black and gray. For one.
Black and gray.
Yeah, black, and then there's one here, black, I think this one is a...
But you saw one engine like that, or two engines like that?
Yeah, I saw the, not the two engines.
Not two engines, yeah. Okay. It's one engine, because they say there were other planes in the area, Edward, that people saw. One was just like this one right here, that was so supposedly following the plane. Did you see more than one plane, or just...
No, only one.
Only one?
Yeah, only one.
No other planes? Okay, because other people said they saw two.
No.
There are reports that a plane just like this, a C-130 with two engines, but that's not what you saw.
This one is a house, you know the house, big airplane?
Yeah.
Yeah, this one, that much lower, the kind of the old ground vibration.
Right.
The dead sound.
But you did not see more than one?
Never there. Only
never
one.
There. Only one, the whole time.
Only one. It looks like the, kind of, shoom. And then I saw the, kind of a feeling break, but the, kind of a one round one is through this way.
So the wings look back up black underneath, and the color, and you say the plane itself looked gray.
Yeah, it's kind of a good, not black, completely black, kind of a dark gray. Yeah?
A dark gray.
Yeah, that's why the, oh, kind of an airplane. Oh, yeah, airplane. Sound is just sound.
Right.
So the wing sound is this one.
Edward's account is quite damaging to the official story. If the plane were to pass on the south side of the station, on its way to top of the light poles, and damage the building, there is no way it could have crossed over Columbia Pike while traveling at over 500 miles per hour. His account contradicts the animation presented in the 9/11 Commission report. Let's take a look at that one more time. While we fully understood the importance of Edward's testimony when we first heard it, we knew it was important to see if his claim could be corroborated or refuted. So we moved up the street to the Citgo gas station. Here we talked with the manager who told us about Robert Tercios, an employee that saw the plane. Please note that the fact that Robert Tercios was at work on 9/11 and was an eyewitness to the plane has been confirmed by his own manager and is officially on record with the station's payroll. Because of this, there is confirmed documented proof that he was at the station and saw the plane on that day. Here's how Robert describes what he experienced.
Okay, so I was saying, I had just come out to do the pump maintenance that morning, you know, taking out the old water, replacing the paper towels, whatnot. I had my cart over here, and when I heard the loud engine sound, you know, like, we normally get flybys from the airplanes, but it was louder than that. So, you know, I started looking where it was coming from. So just looking around and I saw the airplane come down here over the tree.
Okay, let's see. Let's see where you say it was coming down. We're on the south side of the Sitco station. Robert says he saw it come down over here on the north side. Is that right, Robert?
That's correct. It was I saw it come right over the top of that tree there next to the corner of the canopy.
Next to the corner of the canopy. So it came between those two trees?
Yes, that's what I recollect.
Okay.
It seemed to be very, very low to the ground. I thought it was gonna hit the floor, the street here, the ramp. But, so I ran out here to this mound to see if I could see what was gonna happen.
So let's go over there.
Just out here.
Where were you exactly?
Up here.
You were right there, but the mound was a lot smaller, huh?
Yeah, it was a lot smaller.
You have some pictures of that. Why don't we grab those pictures? Can you show us the pictures of how the mound was, Robert?
Well, this is what it looked back then.
Okay, let me zoom in on that.
It was not completed as you see it now.
Right.
It was a little bit shorter.
Right.
So I could see a little bit more than now. But
in fact, let's go up on the mound and so we can get a bit better view of what you actually saw. Okay, so there we go. That's the Pentagon.
Okay,
pretty close view of where the impact point was. Now, Robert, when you ran up to the mound, you saw the plane fly through between these two trees. What happened after that?
Well, as I say, what I saw was a gray plane. I couldn't exactly tell what it was. I mean, it was, couldn't tell the markings on the side of it.
Did you see any markings at all?
No, I don't remember seeing any markings.
Okay. On it. It was like a bright gray or a dull gray?
Kind of bright.
Kind of bright.
Yes, it is not as, it was more of a silver gray kind of.
Okay.
But it was so, kind of quick, maybe 2 seconds when I saw. Just swoop down here, and I tried to follow it, and I saw it lift up a little bit to get over to the side of the bridge here.
To the side of the bridge.
Yes, where you see the do not enter sign. Seems to be that way.
Okay, so you're talking about the. Do not enter sign. Oh, I see. Okay, he's talking about do not enter sign right there.
It's on the billboard.
Right there. So it flew up to go over that.
Yes, it...
Okay. And
then my view was, I could not totally see when it hit the Pentagon. All I saw was it headed straight to it. And then the big explosion, just a fireball and lots of smoke.
Okay, did you see it actually? So you didn't see it hit the Pentagon?
No, the view is not as, it was obstructed still. I could only see the fireball from the explosion.
Did you see it hit any light poles?
No, I may have missed that. I just saw it pick up just to make. No.
You saw it pick up to miss that,
yeah.
Rather than hit any light poles. Did you see it fly over the Pentagon?
Fly over the Pentagon? No. The only thing I saw was when it was a direct, direct line to go into the Pentagon.
Okay. You didn't see it
collide. No, I did not.
Because there were other planes as well. Some people say a gray plane flew over the Pentagon that was following it, but you didn't see that.
No, I did not see any other planes. No.
Okay. Did you see any windows on the plane?
No, I don't.
Did you notice how many engines it had?
I could see the one from my side, the big turbine engine, you know, on the wing.
Okay, just one. Okay, now here we are on the north side of Sitco Station, the Navy Annex Station, or whatever it's called. What's it called?
Navy Exchange.
Navy Exchange, right. Okay. And so now, you pretty much, this is exactly where you saw the plane fly by, right?
Yes. Pretty,
can you point for me how you saw it come?
Well, I would say it seemed to be just over the canopy here, just over the corner of this canopy.
Okay. So it's just over the corner of that canopy.
Over the corner of the canopy, as I said before, it seemed like it was gonna crash onto the street here, but it did. I saw it lift, go up a little bit, headed towards the Pentagon.
It looked like it was going to crash in the street, but then it picked up a little bit.
Yes.
And as far as how it came over this corner, was it more like the wing or the body? Was it the left wing, the right wing, or the actual body?
Oh, no, it was more like the right wing headed.
It was the right wing. So yes. You'd say most of the plane was even further north of the station.
Yes, maybe I would say over the tree here behind me.
Okay, so it kind of flew right over that tree. I see. All right, now, I gave you this piece of paper yesterday to draw a flight path on. That's your drawing, correct?
Yes. Yes, correct.
Okay, I want you to show that to the camera, too. This is the drawing you made of the flight path. Okay, as I was saying to Robert, the official story says that the plane came on the south side of the Sitco and hit the light poles and then went on to the Pentagon. Robert, how certain are you that the plane came on the north side of the station as opposed to the south side?
I am 100% sure that what I saw is the plane come out from this corner of the canopy, over this side of the canopy.
And did the plane look like an American Airlines jet to you?
All I saw was a silver-colored airplane. It was a very quick, I would say about 2 seconds when I saw it. Then I lost sight of it behind the mound. That's when I ran out.
Okay. And then it was already gone?
Yeah. I saw it pick up a little bit.
Oh, okay.
I saw the backside from that. You know, I could not see any markings on that side by then.
Uh-huh. So. Right, I see. So, you saw it, when you ran up to the mountain is when you saw it pick up a bit?
Yes.
Okay. But you're, without a doubt, it was on this side of the station, on the north side of the station.
I'm certain that it was on this side of the station.
Okay. Excellent. Robert, you said that the plane looked silver, but then you said it looked like the color of this car right here. So, it wasn't a super shiny silver. Now, that's an American Airlines jet. There's a color of this silver, and there's that silver. This is with the sun on it, and this is with the sun behind it. And then we have a dull gray military jet here. Another one here. This is a C-130. Did you see one like this?
No, it had a turbine engine, just like the...
It had a turbine engine. Here, let me take that.
Jet.
Okay, jet engines.
Jet engines.
Right, so it did. It was single jet engines, turbine engines. Now, look at this. You said, take a look at this last one. Here's, other people said they saw a white jet like that. Would you say the jet you saw looked exactly like this American Airlines silver jet? Or more like this white jet right here?
To me, it seemed silver. It did not seem white. So I did not see the markings on the side, but the color is more... That.
Was it just like that, or?
I cannot say it was exactly like this. To me, it seemed not as white as this, but it did not seem this silver at me. It seemed like a little bit more gray than silver. It's somewhere in between these two.
Okay, excellent. That's about it. Certainly, Robert, I appreciate your time and your account, your riveting account. It was absolutely amazing.
Robert's account is Earth's